Hello everyone, welcome to the Power Academy. Our today's discussion is related to the green hydrogen policy of India and why India is implementing its maiden green hydrogen and green ammonia policy. How India will going to get benefited from it? These are the ways we will going to explain this topic. As we all know, the climate change due to the excessive emission for the burning fossil fuel is the burning issue in today's time. Because our climate is changing due to the excessive exploitations of our Mother Earth. We are deforesting our planet. We are harvesting every possible non-renewable resources to feed our energy grid. And all our world leaders are expressing their concerns in every year's lavishly organized conference of parties. The resolutions are being signed with zest and zeal. But at the time of implementations, every nation loses their zeal. Because every nation wants to protect their economical interest first. They are not thinking about the environment or the climate change. At the time of implementations, they are looking at the profit. In COP21 or the Paris Agreement, almost all nations except some agreed to keep the global warming at 1.5 degrees centigrade to 2 degrees centigrade. In accordance with the recommendations of Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, in that Paris Agreement, all developed nations also agreed to provide $100 billion fund to all developing nations. But developed nations are yet to finalize that because of their age-old colonial mindset. They want the developing nations to do everything because to keep them poor. But they want their businesses running as usual. By using the conventional fossil fuel, they do not want to change. They do not want to go for the renewable energy. They want to use the fossil fuels. They want to use the conventional energy to run their economy cheap. India is contributing to make the India green and the net zero carbon emission country. Now the India is doing every possible things to make the Indian economy green. By implementing so revolutionary green step, so many revolutionary green steps. India have already expressed its goal to make India net zero carbon emission country by 2070 in COP26. The India has also launched the international solar alliances to promote the solar energy across the world, especially the tropical nations, where the sun is available throughout the year, almost 365 days. So the India's transitions to the green energy has the potential to contribute $1 trillion economical impact by 2030. And it will going to create almost 50 million employment opportunities across the every section of the society of India. This will going to change the India's economical background, Indian economical dependence on the other countries. As we all know, India is pretty vulnerable to the climate change because India is in tropical nations. If the polar ice melt, and then India would lose its valuable and the valuable coastal cities and the coastal resources. To keep this concern in mind, India is investing more and the more in the green energy, investing in the research and development, and also coming up with some green energy policies that will going to change the face of the India's green energy investment. The yesterday India's Ministry of Power notifies the green hydrogen and the ammonia policy to make India green hydrogen hub of the world. So India's dream is big. India is dreaming big to make itself an hydrogen generation country. This will going to help in meeting the target of producing 5 million tons of green hydrogen by 2030 and related development of renewable energy capacity. In today's time, we are using the gasoline, petroleum and the diesel, but the future is hydrogen and the ammonia. In future, the world will use hydrogen to produce the power to run the automobiles, run the planes, run the other resources. But the root question is why we are using the term the green before hydrogen? Because the hydrogen is not green in reality. Because the hydrogen is not available freely anywhere in the world. Hydrogen can only be produced by the electrolysis of the water. The hydrogen can only be produced from the water only. So for electrolysis, the power is required. Therefore, the power which is required for the electrolysis is being generated by the renewable energy. Then that produced hydrogen will be termed as a green hydrogen. If we will going to use the conventional energy, then the hydrogen will not be the green as we are saying so. So we have to use the renewable energy to produce the hydrogen by electrolysis for the water. Using this policy, the government of India is taking the various measures to facilitate the transition from the fossil fuel based feed to the green hydrogen and the green ammonia. The notification of this policy is one of the major steps in this endeavor. So that in order to implement this policy efficiently, government has came up with 10 guidelines, and those are: the first one is the green hydrogen and ammonia manufacturers may purchase the renewable powers from the power exchanges or the set up renewable energy capacity themselves or through any other or the developer or anywhere. Second one is open access will be granted within 15 days of receipt of application. Third one is the green hydrogen manufacturer can bank his consumed power for 30 days. The fourth one is the distribution license can also procure and the supply renewable energy to the manufacturers of the green ammonia and the hydrogen at concessional prices, which will only include the cost of the procurement, wheeling charges, and a small margin as defined by the state commissions. The fifth one is the waiver of the interstate transmission charges for a period of 25 years will be allowed. The sixth one is the green energy manufacturing plant shall be given connectivity to the grid on the priority basis. The seventh one is the benefit of the renewable purchase obligation will be granted incentive to hydrogen manufacturers and the distribution license of consumption of the renewable powers. The eighth one is to ensure the ease of doing business, a single portal for carrying out all the activities, including the statutory clearances, in a time-bound manner will be set up by the AMMONIA. So Indian government is trying to provide everything in an efficient way, in an hurriedly way. And the ninth one is the connectivity as the generation end and the green hydrogen manufacturing end to the ISTS for the renewable energy capacity set up for the purpose of the manufacturing green hydrogen shall be granted on priority. And the last one, the tenth one is the manufacturers of the green hydrogen and ammonia shall be allowed to set up the bunkers near the ports for the storage of the green ammonia for the export use by the shipping. The land for the storage for this purpose shall be provided by the respective port authorities at the applicable charges. So in conclusion, we can say that due to the implementations of this policy, Indian common people will have the access to the green energy and the green fuel. So it is a very beneficial for India and the Indian government and for the Indian economy. This will going to reduce the dependence on the fossil fuel and reduce the crude oil imports. The reduction in the crude oil imports means the more forex reserve savings. And the India will make itself a green energy exporter. That means the India will going to earn the more foreign reserve. More and the more foreign reserves. This will going to help the Indian economy to become a $5 trillion economy. And this is also the right time to tap into the hydrogen's potential to play a key role in taking the critical energy challenges. Because the other nations like the USA, UK, especially the Western countries and the UAE also, is trying to make itself a renewable energy resources country. The countries, those who will going to produce the renewable energy by using the hydrogen, by using the solar, by using the thermal, these kind of things they will going to use by using the hydro. So these countries have already came up with a green hydrogen policy. So India have to came up with these kind of policies to stay into the competitions. And India is seriously trying to get into the competition by producing the hydrogen, by using the renewable energy, because India is a tropical country. India can generate huge amounts of solar energy, the wind energy, and India also have the hydro resources in ample amount. So India will going to increase the productions of the hydrogen by using this renewable energy resources. The recent success of the renewable energy technologies and the electric vehicle have shown that the policy and the technology innovations have the power to build the clean energy industries. In a recent report published by the World Economic Forum, the India has potential to create 50 million jobs, which will contribute $1 trillion in its economy. So it is a huge market, like the digital market. The digital market is hugely impacting our today's economy. Next is the green energy market. It will going to have an exceptional impact on the economy, because each and every unicorns will come up with these sections, these green energy sections, and the India is trying to build itself as a leader of the green energy, because India has taken the initiative of generating the solar power plants in India. India also have the world largest solar power plant, but there is some disadvantages of using the green energy, because at the time of generating the steel, you need some coal. So coal actually came from the coal itself. The high powered coal is required in generating the steel. So there are some manufacturing sections where the green implementation is nearly impossible. But the R&D sections, engineers and the researchers are also working on that to reduce the dependence on some of the things which will going to contribute more and the more pollution in the environment. That is why the world is investing more and the more research and development into the green energy. India is also investing. India is also investing more and the more to produce the green energy more and the more efficient way, more and the more leveraged to the green energy production. Now the first question, the question part, we have reached our question part. The first question is, in which of the following places of India geothermal sources has been found? The first one is Godavari Delta, second is Himalayas, third is West Coast, fourth is all of the above. Now the second question is, which of the following states of India has high potential for the solar energy? The first one is West Bengal, second one is Odisha, third one is Karnataka, fourth one is Rajasthan. If anyone have any question regarding this topic or any topic I have published, then he or she can ask me the question through my email address, which is tuhin.power.academy@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time and thank you for your attention.